Welcome to the Auburn Medical Group channel with Dr. Mark Vaughan, Dr. Gawayne, and Jackie, super patient Jackie, making a third appearance on one of our videos. So today we're talking about this wart on your hand, or I shouldn't say wart. We don't know for sure what this is. And I brought Dr. Gawayne in because sometimes we consult with each other. We'll grab one or the other and bring them into a room and say, hey, what do you think of this? And in this case, we're looking at this growth on Jackie's hand that's been there for
a few weeks.
And does it itch?
No, it's tender.
It's a little tender.
Yeah.
And Dr. Gawayne, I've been looking at it. It's kind of purplish. It's got kind of a crust to it. Yeah. I was thinking this could possibly be a squamous cell carcinoma. And if it is, we'd want to biopsy it with something like a shave biopsy, going kind of wide to make sure we get the whole thing, or in an effort to get it all so we don't have to go back for more. But then I also thought,
I was looking at it too. And initially with the kind of roughness of it, it does have that kind of wart-like texture to it. But if you look very closely, you can see that there's a little base to it, a little pink base. And that's what makes me a little more worried. I think probably the safe thing to do would be to take a biopsy as well, just so we can get a tissue diagnosis. Then we know for sure. That way we're not just kind of blindly freezing and then not really knowing if it comes back.
Should have done more.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So in that case, we'll proceed with the shave biopsy, which is what we scheduled you for anyways.
Right.
The alternative I was thinking was possibly doing cryotherapy, freezing that. And we would present both these options to the patient.
Yep.
We could just do cryotherapy with the risk of not catching a cancer and it comes back.
Yeah, my sisters have all had stuff removed and been diagnosed with skin cancers and stuff. So I just assume, just make sure.
We'll just do the shave.
Yep.
Okay.
Don't want to later on with
Sounds good.
Go in. Are you feeling anything?
Uh-uh.
Draw back. Inject. And that really puffs it up in the area we're working. Are you feeling it? Just the pressure, probably. Because we're putting a lot of fluid into your hand.
Oh, is that what you're doing?
Well, it's an anesthetic.
Oh, okay.
Which is a fluid. A fluid form of anesthetic rather than gas.
Yeah, I have to drive home. That probably is not a good choice.
You don't want to go with the gas?
No. Never done gas. I guess I'm a dentist.
You don't want to.
Oh yeah, it is numb. Now I'm...
So the flexible shaver blade, you know, there is a vein right under this.
Of course there is.
Just thought I'd point that out to us now.
So if I start shooting blood?
There'll be an explanation at least.
Doctor's office if it happens.
Put the sample in the container. No, that's fine. I'll just go like this and it'll fall on the countertop. I can do this. Okay, so the wound seal, wonderful wound seal. You ready, Polly? Let's get some looks at it. One, two, three.
Slow.
And I hold this for about a minute.
Okay.
How are you doing?
Fine.
About a third of the way through. Did you know that Jackie is a Vaughan? Yeah.
My grandfather's parents were both Vaughns because they were first cousins.
Really?
Yes.
We won't put that on the video.
All right.
Thank you, Dr. Gawayne, for helping out with the consult. Thank you, Jackie, for letting us work on it. Hey, if you guys like videos like this, be sure to be subscribed. Also, catch Dr. Gawayne's blog at drgreennight.com. And if you want to see some behind-the-scenes stuff, like some of our shenanigans here, be sure to be a patron on Patreon, like BooBoo Kitty, Lindsay Antwine, and Petra Rosenberg. Until next time, all of us telling you to stay in good health.